What's up guys, Not Super Mario here and welcome back to We Are Who We Are Watch Along episode 6. The previous episode was really good, going back on track in my opinion, because the fourth episode with the party wasn't really what I wanted, or I didn't enjoy it as much as the previous three episodes because it didn't develop characters more and explore their stories, at least I think so. But in the previous episode, everybody was discovering themselves, discovering their sexuality, going through a lot, like issues and stuff that happened, trying new things and exploring if things work like that or they don't, and doing completely new stuff that they're not used to. So it was really nice to see seeing characters explore themselves, their true nature, their sexuality, their everything, and it was really nice to progress the story in that way. I really enjoyed the previous episode. So, of course, I'm excited for the next one. Like I said, I really like this show. It's unique, it's different. I like the characters. I do enjoy the slow pacing, even though maybe sometimes it drags a little bit, but as a show, as a whole, I think it's very different from everything that you see right now on the TV. And Luca Guadagnino is doing yet again another masterpiece, in my opinion, in everything. Storytelling, directing, cinematography is beautiful, that's for sure. And I really do like the characters, even though they are very quirky and weird at times. Especially Frasier can be very weird at times, but it's nice to see those types of people portrayed, that these people that we see in this show, they're not basic, they are interesting, and that's what I like this show, and I'm excited to see what's gonna happen in episode 6. So let's, without further ado, start with episode 6 of We Are Who We Are.
What a small head you have.
Doing sit-ups without anybody spotting you is really tough because you're moving constantly.
Jesus Christ, haven't you had enough, G.I. Jane?
Who's G.I. Jane?
It's an old movie about this woman soldier who shaves her head.
Is it good?
I don't really like sailors.
I'll never kiss a girl again. I'll never kiss anyone again. I'm turning into a monster. Hey.
We're still friends. Call me if you want to. Of course, I'll call you, Britt.
So he bought a book for Jonathan.
Hey.
Hi, hey there.
What was that jump?
Yeah, no. Could I wait here since your door's closed?
Of course.
Okay.
Everything all right? Is there something you need?
Why do I have to need someone to come see you? You didn't count the days.
I know perfectly well it's the 12th day it is.
Okay, I have to go now. You always seem to know what's important, when and for who, don't you?
Why are you so on edge?
Forget it.
Don't be like that. Look, I came out of my meeting to talk to you.
Jesus.
Then go back to your meeting.
What do you think about Frasier?
A very particular kid. Unusual taste and intelligence for his age.
And gifts like those can also be a curse. I worry that a setting like this might be a limitation for his abilities. He always needs new stimuli.
This looks like some secret hideout for a serial killer. Nice cinematography. Damn, I like that shot a lot. Are they going to that island? Probably. Who knows?
Kate!
She's looking for the reception, probably.
Frasier?
Yes.
No.
Okay. I don't need to confiscate your phone, do I?
No.
What do you like about that boy?
I don't know.
He understands me.
How can a fashion victim from New York understand you?
Jesus Christ, he's dead.
He only seems like that. He's not actually that. Or he's not only that.
But are the two of you dating or something? I mean, are you kissing? Because he seems gay. I mean, he's gay, isn't he?
No, we're not dating, Dad. No kissing.
What if I take you there, say, tomorrow, Fraser? Unless I hear from you, I'll swing by and pick you up.
I think he's falling in love.
Pick you up at 9. Even if I do hear from you and you say yes, I'll swing by and pick you up at 9.
I might not be thrilled to hear that he's going out with a 30-year-old man, don't you think?
You're right. It just didn't occur to me to tell you.
Plus, you haven't been around the house much.
It's not about me.
Well, she was fucking the neighbor.
It's just that it doesn't seem like the best idea that he goes out alone with a guy who's much older.
Look around. It's beautiful.
We said, what, 50,000 dead men?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's kind of unidyllic, unusual for a first date. I mean, first whatever.
You have no idea the relief you're missing out on.
I mean, if he doesn't need to piss, he doesn't need to piss. Well, I guess
watch
he's gonna take the piss. Who's coming?
Marta, meet Fraser.
Hi.
Fraser, meet my friend.
Nice to meet you.
Aww.
I heard so much about you.
Yeah.
Are you really as brilliant as Jonathan says?
Poor Fraser.
Brilliant?
Let's go back. Let's put together a band and fucking make a record. And let's send a signed copy to your father.
Fraser Wilson, you're a nutcase.
Oh, and this was the most incredible day of my whole fucking life.
Jesus, their dynamic's so weird.
You still want to be a soldier?
Maybe.
And does your father know when you say soldier, you mean male soldier?
No, he doesn't know.
Do you know Dr. Harris?
Psychologist?
He's actually an endocrinologist. I can take you to see him, just to talk.
Popular vote. We've got much more on President-elect Trump and how his victory is impacting the country.
Who's calling?
Peter Alexander.
Okay. Yeah, I'm coming right over.
A stunning new reality. President-elect Donald Trump.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Complicated business. Complicated.
The great disruptor pulling off an improbable triumph that even his closest aides say they
didn't see
coming.
Is that it? Okay, this was an episode that was really, really slow in my opinion. Even though I said at the beginning that I don't mind the slow pacing, that was maybe a bit too slow. Yet again, we did progress the stories. I like the dynamics that Harper and her dad has, how Fraser's mom is trying to help Harper. Also, I really did enjoy Fraser and Jonathan dynamic and what happened. He thought it's a date or whatever. Then Jonathan brought a girl. Didn't really say if she is his girlfriend, but they had a really great night. But you could see in Fraser's eyes how disappointed he was. Yes, then the wine helped and they had fun, but it was very shocking in the beginning for Fraser to see that Jonathan invited somebody over for his dinner when he thought they're gonna be alone and they're having this special day for themselves. So it's interesting to see how this is gonna progress. Is Jonathan just leading him on, or is he trying to do something with him, even though it is kind of creepy because he is a 30-year-old and Frasier is 16, so kind of very inappropriate. Like Alice Braga's character said in the show, in this episode, I don't know her name, I always forget her name. And I'm like iffy on this episode. Did show progress with the characters, a lot of great stuff have happened, but maybe too slow, like too slow for me. It ended in a way that I'm very excited to see what happened. Yes, we saw that Trump got elected at the end of this episode, but Frasier's mom got a call and something urgent happened and she went away. I don't know what happened, so I'm very excited to see what's gonna happen in the next episode. And I do think this show is gonna get a bit more, let's say, not dramatic, but I think some big things are gonna happen in the last four episodes, because I think we've got 10 episodes of this, or 8, I don't know, you can tell me in the comments down below. You already told me in the previous episodes how many episodes there are, but yeah, I'm excited to see what the future episodes hold for this show, because there's a lot of stuff that need some kind of a resolution. What's gonna happen with Harper, how her dad is gonna take this, how is Frasier's mom gonna like act when she finds out that her partner is banging the neighbor, and how Harper's dad is gonna like act when he finds out. That's gonna be interesting to see, and I wanna see more of this dynamic between Frasier and Jonathan, what that is gonna bring us. And yeah, I am very excited, even though I'm not the biggest fan of this episode, but I think that we are going somewhere that is gonna be very intriguing and exciting to see what's gonna happen with characters. But yeah, tell me your opinion in the comments down below. What did you think about this episode? What did you think about the show in general so far? And yeah, that's gonna be it. If you enjoyed it, leave a like, hit that subscribe button, share this video all over the place, click the bell icon to get notified when I upload, and I'll see you next time. Bye!